Coast Tigers the second period and enjoy the show. In Scotland, a war is raging as Scottish forces try to rebel invaders from nowhere. On a grim Scottish moorland, the weird sisters appear from the mist. They are hatching an evil plot that they will put into place once the war is over.
Where shall we three meet again in the thunder, lightning, or the rain?
When the hurly-burly sound from the battle's lost and won.
Where are the boys?
Upon the
field. There to meet Macbeth.
Fair is foul and foul is fair. Hover under the cloud in the filthy air.
As the sisters fade from view, the tide of the battle finally turns. General Macbeth and Banquo, two thanes of Scotland, threw the Norwegian forces out of the country.
A wounded soldier stumbled into the Scottish camp, King Geoffrey Beasley.
Hail, great friend, how is the battle going?
We lost a lot of men, but we won, thanks to your cousin Macbeth, Lord of Glamis. He's a fearless fighter.
As King Duncan of Scotland enjoys the victory, Ross, a nobleman, comes to speak to him.
In this dismal conflict, the Thane of Carter betrayed you. He has aided Norway's forces.
He was a gentleman in whom I put much trust. No more shall I deceive us. Sentence him to death, named Macbeth, the new Thane of Carter.
I'll see you in Dun.
Before Macbeth, returning home from the battle, come upon the three weird sisters.
So fair and foul a day I have not seen.
What are these? They do not look like the inhabitants of the earth. You should be women, but your beards keep me from believing it.
All hail Macbeth, hail to thee, Thane of Glamis.
All hail Macbeth, hail to thee, Thane.
All hail Macbeth, that should be king hereafter.
Macbeth is shocked speechless. The witches have predicted that he will gain another moment in this title and become king.
Good sir, why do you fear these things that sound so good? You greet my noble partner with great predictions, but you say nothing to me. If you can see the future and tell me how it will turn out.
Hail, lost me, Macbeth, but then much greater.
Hail, not so happy and much happier.
You will follow kings, though you be not.
The witches vanish.
Your children will be kings.
You shall be king.
And Thane of Gower, too, they say.
Ross and Angus arrive.
The king has received news of your success, Macbeth, and to honor you, he named you Thane of Cawdor.
Can the witches speak true?
The Thane of Cawdor lives. Why do you dress me in proud robes?
The Thane of Cawdor is still alive, but he's been sentenced to death and deserves to die.
Thane of Glamis and of Cawdor, the Lord just told the truth. Will I be king as well? Stars, hide your fires. Let not light see my black and deep desires.
Back at Macbeth's castle, Lady Macbeth gets a letter from her husband, telling him about the meeting with the witches in his new title.
Alone she faces the room. She wants Macbeth to be king, but she believes the only way that will happen is if she kills Duncan. She doubts he will do it.
You can be what you are promised, yet I fear your nature. You too are full of the milk of human kindness. You are not without ambition, but you are without the evil which can accompany it.
Your ladyship,
what's your news?
King Duncan will die very late.
This is great news. Come, you spirits, fill me from crown to toe with cruelty, so we can do what we must do. Great Glamis, worthy Cawdor, these are great titles, and more will follow. We need to do what we can assure our future.
Duncan will be here tonight.
Yes, and when will he leave?
Tomorrow.
Never shall he see tomorrow's sun. My Thane, look like the innocent father, but be the servant of it.
Macbeth realizes the chief means that he must seek to honor the king, but be ready to kill him.
He wants to be king, but he doesn't want to kill Duncan.
We will speak further.
At evening, the king and his lords arrive at Macbeth's castle. Welcome, Your Highness.
Thank you, Julie.
Later that evening, as Lady Macbeth, Duncan, and the other guests enjoy the royal banquet, Macbeth is deeply disturbed by the thoughts of killing Duncan.
If it were to be done, then it would be well to do it quickly. But Duncan's here, double trust. And if I am his subject and his host, I should shut the door of his murder, not carry it out of myself.
Why have you left the banquet?
You will proceed no further with this business.
What? Are you afraid of acting to win what you desire?
I do all a man should do, and he who dares to do more is not a man.
When you dare to commit murder, then you are a man.
If we should fail?
Fail? Screw your courage, this sticking place, and will not fail. When Duncan is asleep, I will use wine to make his two bear sleep. When they lie in sleep, what can't we do to the unguarded Duncan?
guards shall bear the yoke of our action.
Duncan's guards are asleep. Lady Macbeth will serve them drug wine. Macbeth stands at the bottom of the stairway, still arguing with himself about whether or not to kill Duncan. He stares at the patterns of light on the dark wall by the castle's flickering torches.
Is this a dagger I see before me? Vandal tore my hand. Come, let me clutch you. I have you not, and yet I see you still. Are you but a dagger of the mind, a false creation of a fevered brain?
In the distance, a bell rings.
I go. The bell invites me. Hear it not, Duncan. Either it is a knell. It is a knell that summons you to heaven or to hell.
Macbeth climbs the stairway on his way to kill Duncan.
When Macbeth returns, he has the bloody daggers of Duncan's two guards with him. Lady Macbeth meets him at the bottom of the stairs.
I have done the deed. This is a sorry sight. Did you hear a noise? I thought I heard a voice cry. Sleep no more. Macbeth does murder sleep. Macbeth shall sleep no more.
Foolish thought. Why did you bring the daggers back? They must lie there. Go and smear the sleeping guards with Duncan's blood.
I'll go no more. I'm afraid to think of what I've done. So look on it again, I dare not.
The sleeping and dead are but pictures. Duncan bleeds. I'll cover the faces of the guards with his blood, for it must seem their guilt.
She marks the Duncan blood.
My hands are now of your color, but a little water clears us of this deed. How easy it is.
The next morning, Macbeth gets dressed, unaware of Duncan's murder.
Is the king stirring, worthy thing?
Not yet.
He commanded me to wake him.
Macbeth leads Macbeth and Duncan's womb, and then returns to learn office.
Will the king be leaving today?
He will.
It's been a stormy night. People say they heard a voice cry. Some say they were earthquakes.
It was a rough night.
Oh, horror!
What's the matter?
Ring the alarm bell! Murder and treason! Your royal master's been murdered!
What? In our house?
Too cruel anywhere.
Duncan's sons, Malcolm and Delane, join the lords.
What's the trouble?
Your royal master's been murdered.
By whom?
His two guards, it seems. Their hands and faces were marked with blood. So are their daggers.
Oh, I wish I hadn't killed them.
Why did you then?
Seeing that her husband is losing his nerve, Lady Macbeth pretends to faint. All the lords rush to her aid, this gives Macbeth time to pull himself together.
Malcolm and Dolan move aside.
We are next in line to the crown. Whomever killed our father will soon come after us.
We cannot trust anyone. Here, there are daggers and men's mouths.
I'll go to England.
That's what happened.
Because of their sudden disappearance, Malcolm and Donald Bain become suspects in their father's funeral. In their absence, Macbeth becomes king.
He has it all now. Kingship, Lammas, Cawdor. And yet, I fear he played most foully for it. But it was also prophesied that my sons would become kings. But hush no more.
Macbeth fears his suspicious friend will be to help Duncan's sons gain back the throne.
Tonight we hold a feast here, and I'll request your presence.
As you wish.
Are you going riding with your son this afternoon?
Yes.
Till supper time, then.
Danko departs. Macbeth worries about the witch's prophecy to Danko. He is king now, but will Danko's sons overthrow him? Both Danko and Cleon must be killed then.
Two murderers enter the room.
Have you considered my request?
My lord, I'm not so kicked around by the world, and also hungry, I don't care what you do.
I am the same. I am so sick of bad luck and trouble that I risk my life on any bet.
Go then. It must be done tonight.
The motto is leave. Lady Macbeth walks through the old castle. She thinks about what Macbeth did in order to be king.
Now we have no peace of mind. Was it worth it?
Oh, full of scorpions is my mind, your wife.
She tried.
Outside on the dark beast, the murderer cut their throats.
That night, Macbeth hosts a royal dinner. All the Scottish noblemen are there, except for Bangle, who is also suspicious of Macbeth.
Correct. Yeah, he's even better. I did the same for Fleance.
Well, sir, Fleance escaped.
Macbeth returns to his guests. He finds there's no seat for him at the table.
May I please inherit a seat?
The table is full.
Here's a pistol here.
Macbeth looks at the chair and sees Banquo's buddy Ghost sitting there.
Which one of you have done this?
What, my lord?
You can't say I did it.
His Highness is not well.
Please, sit, my friends. My husband is often this way. He has done so too. Please, keep your seats.
She rushes to Macbeth and whispers to his ear.
What's the matter? You're staring at an empty chair.
I saw Banquo. It used to be that a man would die, and that would be the end. But now they rise again.
The ghost leaves the table.
My worthy lord, your friends are wondering about you.
My friends, do not worry for me. I have a strange illness that is nothing to those who know me. Come, love and health to all. I drink to the general joy of the table and to our friend, Banquo, whom we miss. Would that he be here.
Macbeth sees Banquo's ghost, the appeal. He screams and throws the glass at the hallucination.
Ah! Get out of my sight. Let the earth keep you. Get away, you horrible shadow.
What side, my lord?
How can you look upon such sight and not turn white with fear?
What side, my lord?
My friends, he grows worse and worse. Please, go at once. Good night.
The guests leave quickly. Banquo's ghost is gone.
It will have blood, they say. Blood will have more blood. Tomorrow I must go to the Weird Sisters. They must tell me more, for I must know the worst.
Macbeth is worried about Macduff. He seems to have figured out the truth about him. Macbeth also has heard that Malcolm Duncan's son has joined forces with King Edward of England to try to take the throne back.
Meanwhile, the three witches are boiling a foul potion in a cauldron.
Double, double, toil and trouble, fire burning, cauldron bubble.
Fillet of a fenny snake in the cauldron boil and bake. I am Newton, toe of frog, wool of bat and tongue of dog. For a charm of powerful trouble, like hell a broth boil and bubble.
Double, double, toil and trouble, fire burning, cauldron bubble.
By the pricking of my thumb, something wicked. Open
how now, you secret black and midnight hags? However you come to know it, answer me what I ask you.
Would you like from our mouths or our back?
Call him. Let me see him.
The witches pour a jug of blood into the cauldron, and a vision of a skull and armor rises from the pot.
Macbeth, beware of the duck. Beware of the thing. Fight.
You have stated my fear.
A second vision quickly appears.
Macbeth, black and scorn of the power of man, and a woman born to honor.
Then live, Macbeth. Why should I fear you?
Is there a vision of fear?
Macbeth shall never be vanquished, but shall burn and hope to hide. Then some now shall come against him.
That will never be. Yeah. Tell me, shall Banquo's sons ever reign in this kingdom?
A fourth vision rises from the pot. Eight kings with Banquo's bloody ghost standing from behind them smiling.
Filthy axe, why do you show me this? Can this be?
Back at his castle, Macbeth becomes more unstable. When he enters the throne room with an urgent message.
My lord, I bring you word. I've done this blood to England.
Macbeth realizes that Macduff has turned against him and will help Malcolm try to overthrow him.
Then I will seize his castle. I'll kill his wife, his children, and all of his people, all the people in his castle.
At King Edward's castle, Malcolm and Macduff prepare to attack Macbeth.
Each new morn, new widows howl, new orphans cry.
Our country sings, it weeps, it bleeds, and each new day, it gashes at its true wounds.
No devil is more evil than Macbeth.
I think there be many hands raised in Scotland and caused, and gracious England has offered thousands more. I shall tread upon the tyrant's head.
Fox enters the castle.
My gentle cousin, welcome.
What's the nearest grief?
Your castle is attacked. Your wife and babe savagely slaughtered.
What? All my pretty chickens and their dam in one fell swoop?
I can speak like a man.
Bucket Dunstan, greeting Macbeth's handmaiden, is great about the lady's constant sleepwalking. She fears that Lady Macbeth is going insane. She asks the doctor to help bring her outside the lady's room.
Pretty child is fast asleep. Look how she rubs her hands.
I have no courage to continue this in the horror room.
Lady Macbeth is locked out of the room, seriously rubbing her hands together as if she was washing up.
Out, damn spot, out, I say. Who would have thought the old man to have so much blood in him?
Did you hear that?
Dana Fife had a wife. Where is she now? What? Will these hands never be clean?
She has broken what she should not, I am sure not.
Here's the smell of blood still. All the perfumes of Arabia will not sweeten this little lamb. Oh, oh, oh.
This disease is beyond my practice. I cannot cure an infected mind.
Here, I tell you yet again, Banquo's buried, and he cannot come out of his grave.
Keep an eye on her and let's not tell anyone what we're doing tonight.
In Dunsmuir, several scouts give Macbeth reports of the advancing army, which numbers 10,000 men.
Bring me no reports till Burnham Wood comes to Dunsinane. I cannot fear. I'll fight till from my bones the flesh is hacked. How is your patient, doctor?
Lots of sick, total fancies that keep her from rest.
Cure of that.
The patient has sent to herself.
Their medicine to the dogs? I'll have none of it. Come, give me my, put on my armor, give me my sword.
At Burnham Wood, near Dunsinane, Malcolm and the English army are joined by the Scottish rebels.
The army is assembled at the foot of the hill of Macbeth's castle. Malcolm looks up at the castle.
What's the tyrant doing?
He's preparing to defend his castle. Some skin's gonna happen.
Now does he feel a secret murder sticking to his hands?
I hope I'm the one who makes him pay for them.
Each man, cut a branch and carry it in front of you, disguised as trees, will sneak up his own surprise and attack. Hard.
In the middle of preparation for the battle, Macbeth hears screams from the side of the castle.
Ah!
What is that noise?
It's the cry of Bolo, my lord.
The handmaiden goes to check on the noise and quickly returns.
The queen is dead, my lord.
She's killed herself?
The handmaiden nods silently.
Out, out, brief candle. Life's but a walking shadow. A poor player who struts and frets his hour upon the stage, and then is heard no more. It is a tale told by an idiot, signifying that, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing.
The scout bursts into the room.
My lord, I should report what I saw, but no one knows how to do it. As I stood my watch upon the hill, I looked toward Burnham, and I think the woods began to move.
Liar and slave!
You can see the woods moving within 3 miles of moving forest.
If you speak false, upon the next tree you shall hang alive. So Burnham Wood comes to Dunsinane. Now Burnham Wood comes to Dunsinane. Ring the alarm bell. Elise will die with armor on her back.
Outside Dunsinane, Malcolm's troops have thrown down their branches, and the battle has begun. Macbeth's troops are outnumbered and overwhelmed, but he fights on, killing several rebels. Meanwhile, Macduff seeks out Macbeth, hoping for revenge.
Tyrant, show your face! If you be slain and not by my sword, my wife and children's ghosts will haunt me still.
Macbeth appeals.
I've avoided you. My blood, my soul is too wet with blood of yours already.
I have no words. My voice is in my sword already, bloody villain.
You waste your effort. I live a charmed life which will not yield to those of woman born.
I was not born, but ripped out of my mother's womb.
Curse be the tongue that tells me so. I will not fight with you.
Then surrender, coward.
No, though Burnham Wood come to them today, and I have not woman born, I will fight to the last. Lay on, Macduff, and curse be him that first cries. Hold, enough.
They fight. Macbeth is killed.
What? In the dark room of Dunsinane, Malcolm and the nobles celebrate their victory. They are discussing plans to crown Malcolm King of Scotland. And Macduff enters and places his bloody sword with Macbeth's bloody head upon it.
Hail King, for so you are.
We have much to do. We will call home our friends that fled this tyranny and dead butcher. Wait. like queen. So it all at once. Thanks to all. We invite you to see this crown that's gonna